students, this is a diagram of a satellite system. This is the diagram of a satellite system. This is the diagram of a satellite system. This system consists of two parts. This part is dedicated for coupling frequency. This part is for downlink. First, this, let's consider this part. This is your antenna. This part consists of an user, terrestrial system, earth station connected with an antenna. This is your transmitting antenna. Now the receiving antenna, between the transmitting and the receiving antenna, there is a satellite. So when the receiving antenna is connected with the same earth station, terrestrial system, user. So a terrestrial network connects the user to the earth station. A terrestrial network connects the user to the earth station. The terrestrial network may be a telephone or dedicated link to the earth station. So satellite, here the satellite receives uplink frequency from the transmitting antenna. The satellite receives uplink frequency from the transmitting antenna. It then amplifies and retransmits back to the receiving antenna. This is parabolic antenna. This may be a dish antenna. This may be a dish antenna or a parabolic antenna. Satellite receives the uplink frequency from the transmitting antenna. This is transmitting PX, transmitting antenna. This is receiving antenna. So satellite receives the uplink frequency from the transmitting antenna and then amplifies it and retransmits them back to the downlink frequency which is different from uplink frequency to avoid interference, so that the interference may not happen. This uplink frequency, the satellite receives the signal from the antenna at an uplink frequency, and it then amplifies and transmits back to the receiving antenna, and the receiving antenna sends it to the earth station through a downlink frequency, which is different from the uplink frequency, and to avoid interference. Now the earth station is again connected to terrestrial network and the user. What happens here? Signal receives at the terrestrial network through this downlink frequency will be demodulated. Signal receives at the terrestrial network through this downlink frequency will be demodulated. Signal receives to the terrestrial network through this downlink frequency will be demodulated by the signal receives to the terrestrial network through this downlink frequencies will be demodulated by the user to recover the baseband signal. Here the receiving antenna receives the signal from the satellite. Then this is the receiving signal. The satellite sends the signal to the receiving antenna at a downlink frequency. This downlink frequency is different from this uplink frequency to avoid interference. Then this signal is transmitted again back to the earth station and the terrestrial system. The signal received at the terrestrial system through downlink frequency will be demodulated by the user to recover the baseband signal. This is the signal which is sent by the user to terrestrial system, then earth station, then to the transmitting antenna. So from the transmitting antenna, signal is sent to the satellite. Then the signal is received by the receiving antenna from the satellite. Signal is sent to the satellite by the transmitting antenna through an uplink frequency. And the signal is received by the receiving antenna through a downlink frequency. That downlink frequency will be that downlink frequency of the receiving antenna will be sent back again to the earth station, then terrestrial system, then to the user. User demodulate the downlink frequency signal is received by downlink frequency. User demodulate the downlink frequency signal sent by terrestrial system to the user. User demodulate the terrestrial system. User demodulate the signal sent by terrestrial system to the user to recover or to retrieve back the original baseline signal. Some data bit will send to the terrestrial system through an uplink frequency. I have already displayed you the block diagram of uplink frequency. I have already told you the block diagram of downlink frequency. So, in the uplink frequency, there is a bandpass filter, there is an up converter, there is an antenna. Up converter consists of mixture with carrier. Frequency, there is a product modulator. I've already told you the block diagram of uplink and downlink frequency. The signal is generated from the user to terrestrial system by using uplink frequency. The signal is received from terrestrial system to the user by using downlink frequency. Now, terrestrial network is a telephonic network or a dedicated switch connected to the earth station. A dedicated link or a telephonic network connected to the earth station. So, signal is received by the user, signal is sent by the user to the terrestrial system. Earth station receives the signal at an uplink frequency. Then the signal will be sent to the transmitting antenna. The transmitting antenna will send the signal to the satellite. Satellite, what will do? Satellite amplifies the signal. And after amplification, it will send the signal to a downlink frequency, transmit the signal to the receiving antenna at a downlink frequency, which is different from the uplink frequency to avoid interference. Then one by one it is received by the earth station, terrestrial system, then finally the user. Remember the downlink frequency block diagram, there is a demodulator at the end. What user do? User demodulates the downlink frequency signal to retrieve back or to recover the original baseband signal. Here, the user demodulate the downlink frequency signal to. Here, the user demodulate the downlink frequency signal to recover or to retrieve back the original baseband signal. So, in this way, the information that is sent by the user at an uplink frequency will be received and recovered by the user here at a downlink frequency, which is different from the uplink frequency, so that there will be no signal interference. This is the block diagram of a satellite communication system, satellite system. In the next half, I will give you another lecture on the advantages of digital transmission system over satellite transmission system. Why do we use digital transmission system instead of using satellite system? I've already discussed to you the advantages and disadvantages of satellite communication system. Now, I'll discuss with you another thing, some elementary definitions of satellite communication system, and the advantages of digital transmission system over satellite communication system, that I will discuss with you. The advantages of digital communication system over satellite transmission system. Advantages of digital transmission system over satellite transmission system, that I will discuss with you. After discussing some common term that is used in satellite communication systems. So this is the block diagram of, this is the entire block diagram of satellite transmission system. Hope you have understood how uplink frequency is used by the user to transmit the signal to the terrestrial system, how the earth station is connected with the terrestrial system by using a telephone switch or a dedicated link, what is transmitting antenna, what is receiving antenna, what is the job of the satellite here, how the receiving earth station receives the signal at a downlink frequency which is different from the uplink frequency. The terrestrial system receives the signal at a downlink frequency which is different from the uplink frequency. There will be no interference. User finally demodulates the signal at a downlink frequency to recover the original baseband signal. So here there is one type of modulation, here there is demodulation. Here we use up converter, where we use mixture and local oscillator to generate carrier. Then we use FM or QPSK modulation for modulation technique. Here we use demodulator to demodulate the signal along with the use of down converter. Here up converter and a modulator, FSK, QM or QPSK modulator. Here there is down converter with a demodulator to demodulate and receive and retrieve back the original baseband signal. So this is your satellite block, the communication block diagram. In the next half, I will discuss with you some common terms used in satellite, some very common terms used in satellite communication system, and some test and satellite frequency and terrestrial frequency and the advantages of digital transmission over satellite transmission system. So this is your satellite communication system.